Iraqi forces have advanced into the outskirts of western Mosul on the second day of an offensive aimed at driving ISIS terrorists from that city. It's part of an operation that began more than 4 months ago. The U.S. is providing close air support, along with some special operations forces embedded with Iraqi troops. Today, the U.S. commander of the Joint Combined Task Force said American troops are closer to the front now than at any time in the 2.5-year-old fight against ISIS.
It is true that we're operating closer and deeper into the Iraqi formation. So we adjusted our posture during the East Mosul fight, and we embedded advisors a bit further down into the formation.
National security correspondent Jennifer Griffin is traveling with Defense Secretary Jim Mattis in Iraq. She reports on the former general's return to a familiar and still dangerous theater.
Defense Secretary Jim Mattis landed in Baghdad a day after Iraqi forces backed by U.S. and coalition warplanes began a long-awaited assault on western Mosul to rid ISIS from its last major stronghold in Iraq. Artillery and airstrikes allowed Iraqi forces to advance from four sides. Inside the city, a terrified population was told not to come out of its homes. On his first visit to Baghdad as defense secretary, Mattis wanted to clarify why the U.S. is in Iraq after all these years and why it is not.
We're not in Iraq to seize anybody's oil.
Even though Trump hinted earlier this month that he would have prosecuted the war differently.
So we should have kept the oil, but okay. Maybe you'll have another chance.
When President Trump chose as his defense secretary a no-nonsense general known for his frank talk and the fear he inspires in the enemy, he chose a deferential warrior who is not afraid to speak his mind.
I think all of us here in this room, all of us in America have generally paid for our gas and oil all along, and I'm sure that we will continue to do so in the future.
When asked about the executive order banning Iraqis temporarily from getting visas for the U.S., a court has halted that order, but Mattis says in the future there will be exceptions for Iraqis who worked and fought for the U.S. military.
I have not seen the new executive order, but I right now am assured that we will take steps to allow those who have fought alongside us, for example, to be allowed in to the United States.
The former Marine general first began fighting in Iraq in 1991. He led U.S. Marines into combat during the invasion of Iraq and led them again through both battles of Fallujah. Today, as Iraqi forces accompanied by several hundred U.S. military advisors try to free 750,000 residents of Iraq's second largest city from 3,000 ISIS fighters, the main thing on his mind were his troops.
The attack into the city is something I don't want to go into details about because I owe confidentiality to the troops who are actually making the attack, but at the same time, we are very close to it, if not already engaged in that fight.
Mattis said the rules of engagement have not changed for U.S. troops advising Iraqi forces.
The U.S. forces continue in the same role that they were in East Mosul, and the coalition forces are in support of this operation. And we will continue, as you know, with the accelerated effort to destroy ISIS.
Mattis was briefed by the top U.S. general in Iraq, Lieutenant General Steve Townsend, and met the Iraqi prime minister, who Vice President Mike Pence had met in Munich days earlier.
Here in Iraq, the fight for Mosul will be long and difficult and won't end there. The president has given his commanders 30 days to come up with a new plan to defeat ISIS. For all of them, the clock is ticking. Traveling with the Defense Secretary, Jennifer Griffin, Fox News.